again about surveying. What is surveying? Surveying is an art of determining relative positions or points on the ground or above the ground. Surveying is a main concept which is used for civil engineering to measure or to know the details of the earth, to know the details of the ground level position, to know the plans, sections, etc. Survey is divided into two types. One is plain survey and other one is geodetic survey. What is plain survey? We all know that our earth is in spherical shape. This earth will be considered as plain in plain survey. Like we will neglect all this curvature shape in plain survey. Only this plain surface will be considered in plain survey. This plain surveying is done for small areas, not more than 250 kilometers. And coming to second type of surveying, this is geodetic surveying. Geodetic surveying is used to measure the earth by considering the curvature of the earth. We know all that our earth surface is in spherical shape. In plain surveying, only we will consider this plain area. But in geodetic surveying, we will consider this earth surface also, this curved surface also. By dividing small parts, we will find out this area. This geodetic surveying is done for large areas, more than 250 kilometers square. The purpose of surveying, the main purpose of surveying is to prepare the plans and to prepare the maps. The purpose of surveying is to prepare the maps. We have different types of maps. One is engineering map. Engineering maps. Military maps. Military maps. And cadastral maps. Etc. To prepare the maps, we will use the survey. That is the main purpose of the survey. And to prepare the plan of any building, of any structure or shape of the earth, survey will be considered. That is, these two are the main purpose of the survey. And coming to principle of surveying, what is principle of surveying means? We have two principles in surveying. One is to work from whole to part. To work from whole to part means, if we consider earth's shape, we will divide our earth into so many parts as in triangles. Triangle 1, 2, 3, 4. We will divide our earth into different parts, small, small parts. Then we will calculate the shape, area of 1, area of 2, 3, etc. And we will add all that areas. Then we will get the total area of our place. This is first principle of surveying. And second principle of surveying is to locate a new station by knowing two points. By knowing two points, how we can do the survey means, if we know two points, another point can be measured by using this principle. If we know point A and B, if we want to survey this point, to locate this point, we will draw a triangle so that this unknown point can be measured by using these two known points. This is another principle of surveying. One more example, if we know two points A, B and we want to know this thing, we can draw draw a straight line but perpendicular line with 90 degrees, we can calculate this another unknown point. So that is our second principle, means to locate a new station. This is our new station. To locate a new station by at least two measurements, known measurement, by at least two known measurements. This is the second principle. There are two principles for surveying. One is to work from whole to part. In this, we will divide area into small, small parts and we will calculate the whole area. And to locate a new station by at least two known measurements. These two are the principle of surveying. Coming to classification of survey, we have mainly four classification of surveying. One is classification based on instruments. By what instruments we are surveying, using that instruments, classification done with so many types. And second one, classification based on methods. Methods means which method we are using for survey. That method, second one. Third one, classification based on object of survey. The purpose of survey or the objective of survey. By objective of survey, survey is classified. And fourth classification based on nature of the field. These four are the main classification of survey. But one by one we will discuss what is classification based on instruments used. For survey, we will use different types of instruments. By instruments, the survey is divided as chain survey, compass survey, plane survey, theodolite, so on. What is chain survey? Chain survey is used to measure the plane areas for small areas. And we will get linear measurements by chain surveying. By spreading the chain, we will calculate the area of a small ground. And coming to second one, compass surveying. Compass is an instrument which is used to measure the angular measurements in survey. We will get angular measurements by using compass surveying. Coming to next one, plane table survey. Plane table survey is a survey where directly we will get the plan of the area by using this plane table. What we will do in this plane table means we will calculate, we will draw a sheet. What is actual area on the ground will be plotted on a paper by using this plane table survey. Coming to theodolite survey. Theodolite is an instrument which is used to measure the angles as well as linear measurements. By using theodolite, we can both the measurements can be get angles and linears. By using theodolite survey, we can also find out the slopes of the ground. Coming to leveling. Leveling is an instrument which is nearly same like theodolite to know the slopes of the ground. Tachometric surveying. Tachometric surveying is used to measure the slopes of the ground. Our earth is in irregular shape. That shapes can be found out by using tachometry. Next one, EDM. EDM is an instrument which is used to know the angular as well as linear measurements. EDM full form means electromagnetic distance measurement instrument. This EDM, electromagnetic distance measurement, is used to measure the total area at a time by angular or linear. This is the presently using equipment. And photogrammetry or aerial survey. In this aerial survey, by using planes or other, we will take the pictures of our earth to draw the maps. And remote sensing is used where we cannot go directly. From here we can measure the area. That type of instrument is remote sensing instrument. Total station. total station is a combination of EDM and theodolite. This is the most accurate instrument. Total station is a most accurate instrument which is used in survey for nowadays. GPS, Global Positioning System. GPS is also a new generation instrument which is used to survey the plane surface or slope surface. This is about based on the instrument survey is divided. Next one, classification based on methods employed. What are the methods employed for surveying? That is triangulation survey and traverse survey. These two are the two methods used for surveying. Triangulation means we will whole area will be divided as a triangle, then it is calculated. That is a triangulation survey. Traverse survey means duplicate measurements will be taken, then the area will be surveyed by this traverse survey. Coming to classification based on objective of survey. Objective or purpose. What is our main purpose? Based on that, this survey is divided as geological survey, archaeological survey, mine survey, military survey. Purpose for knowing the earth shape, knowing the earth structure, knowing the earth conditions, this geological survey is used to know the surface of the earth. This survey will be used. Archaeological survey means any other spaces were going on this survey, then this is archaeological survey. Mine surveying is used for mining any area. We have in Adilabad district coal mine. For mining, this mine survey is used. Military survey. For military purposes, we will go for this survey. Classification based on nature of the field. What field we are doing surveying? Based on that, the marine survey, astronomical survey, land survey.